this is where we could wrap up our discussion on Stern and move on to speaking a little bit about Chicago Booth. So my first question is that how, so I mean, besides the fact that you were interviewing with a current student, right? A second year student.
Second year student.
So did you speak, okay, so my first question to you is that did you get to speak anyone on campus when you were on Chicago Booth?
Yeah, so I reached Chicago on 31st, just after a Stern interview. I took a flight to Chicago. I reached there on 31st. On 1st, I did campus visit. I did the informational session. Then I had a lunch with current students. And the highlight of my US trip was in the second half. I took a 3-hour class from Raghuram Rajan. So that was like the best part of my US trip, better than any interviews that I took. And towards the end of the class, I went to Raghuram Rajan, sir. It was a privilege to be part of your class. I have come from India to interview, and the first question, did you like the class? I was like, yes, sir. That was superb. And he was very, he being a central governor, and he's one of the most respected professors in Chicago Booth as well. But he was very down to earth, and I was a prospective student, and he entertained me for 2-3 minutes post class. So that was the best part. So yeah, during those interactions, I made sure that I have enough to say in interview. I have enough data points which I can spill over if I get a chance in interview.
So what sort of data points did you collect during your sort of interaction with Booth alums on campus? So what specifically 2 or 3 things that you deliberately look to pick?
So the first thing was that the program flexibility part. How many core courses, how can I take different courses, and how many specialization, or how many, they call it something else, sorry, I forgot. So how many specialization can I take, and how flexible is Booth? These were very critical data points in the sense that Booth puts a lot, Booth puts a lot of stress on flexibility of curriculum. So that's the best part of that school, and I just wanted to make sure that I have enough data points to say, okay, see you for that part, flexibility part. I have enough data points to present an interview. So few things that I did, how many specialization, what all courses can you take. I can, best part about Booth is that I can take classes with PhD students as well, or I can do any other course in other University of Chicago colleges, and then I can file for petition. So it's very flexible in this regard. Only 3 core courses are there, and rest of the you can choose.
I believe Booth calls this designing your own curriculum. A lot of schools have come up with a very similar phrases, but I think Booth was the initial school that did this. So great. So let's just get to the point where you started interviewing with the second year students. How long did your interview last with the person?
So my interview was at 11 a.m. I reached there at 10:15, and then there were a couple of first year students. Mm-hmm. So they were there to address any doubt, or they were just make us comfortable. So I did a chit chat with first year student, and there was another guy who is U.S. Army vet. He also came from Colorado to take interview. So I was like chit-chatting with him, and then my interviewer came. She's a very, Brittany Henry, she's second year student of NYU Stern, and she's head of African American group at NYU Stern. So then she came and took me to the interview room. In interview room, it was a very chilled out experience. It lasted for 45-50 minutes, and it was more of a conversation than interview. And she had initially 4-5 questions written in a pad which she asked, and then she made a three page notes on my interview. She kept on writing throughout the interview, but she was very nice. And
so throughout the interview, like, I mean, did she used to ask you a question and then you started speaking, or did she interject you a lot during the interview? Because you said that it was conversational, so how did the conversation flow?
Typically she asked me a question, and then she asked me a question, and when I started responding, she started noting down. I guess they want to make sure that what I have written in application and how I am presenting, so both are similar. So I guess students have 2-2.5 page of notes to make for each candidate. So she kept writing, and in between she used to crack a joke, or she started teasing me. So in one of my weakness, I said that I at times become very demanding, which my subordinates don't like. So she kept on teasing me throughout the interview. So she was very nice in that regard.
And was she from the finance background, the background that you are from?
Yes, she had a 4 months internship at Bank of America in investment banking, and that was her undergraduate experience. But still, they sort of try to map our profile with current student profile, and then
So any kind of
schedule it.
technical or finance heavy questions that were asked to you, or was it just a kind of a fit question?
Yeah, it was kind of set questions, nothing as such, nothing special about finance. I mean, nothing into finance, sorry.
So nothing, no questions on like, you know, what the macro economy is doing or where India is moving or something like that. No questions, right?
Yes, no, nothing. No questions on that. So towards the end of interview, I said that I want to work in, I would like to work in Chicago, and JP Morgan covers its agriculture, I mean commodity globally from Chicago office. So I would like to work there. So she asked me why agri, why consumer and retail. So I was prepared for that answer.
So, all right, so just the parting thoughts. So, anything you would like to add about your interview experience at NYU slash Booth? I mean, the primary differences between the two, except for the fact that the current students interviewed you at Booth versus that NYU
Yeah.
admissions officer interviewed you at NYU. So, any kind of prominent differences just to wrap this discussion up?
So the commonality in both the interviews was that similar set of questions were asked. It was set question, nothing specific. I mean, and they didn't grill me. Both of the interviews were very good. I mean, both of the interviewers were very nice throughout the process. And the difference between so she being a second year student in Chicago Booth, she could relate to us. I mean, she related to me throughout the interview. Okay, when I was in IB, I used to do this. While when admission committee was taking my interview in NYU's turn, so she was kind of judging me through. I thought that she is judging me throughout the interview, but in Chicago Booth, she was more of it was more of conversational, and she kept on writing the notes.
Okay, got it. So, what kind of questions did you ask when you were wrapping up your interview? So, the final question, do you have any questions for us? That is usually asked, right? So, the kind of questions you would have asked to an admissions officer, I'm assuming that it would be different from the ones that you would have asked to a current year student. So, can you throw
Yeah.
some light on that?
So in NYU's turn, as I told earlier, that they have started a specialization in fintech. So I started on that. Okay, see, I'm very interested in fintech, and I believe this is going to affect investment banking in 10, 15 years down the line. So, do you have any fintech society? How many students typically take fintech as a specialization? So, she thought that I am genuinely interested in fintech specialization also. She said, okay, you can start a club. At present, we don't have any club, but you can start a club. You are most welcome to take the initiative. The second question that I asked, apart from having a world-class academicians and very robust placement cell, I mean, career services, what else do you think does NYU Stern has, which differentiates it NYU Stern from other B schools? So she was like, yeah, the flexibility again for 25% of curriculum you can take in any other college of New York University, any other school from New York University. So it's very flexible in that regard. So these two questions, and I don't believe, yeah, these two questions I asked Sarah in NYU. In Chicago, but since it was more of conversational, so I started with random walks. A random walk is a program where first year students go to random places across the globe. So I asked about a random walk. I would like to go to this Latin America and Africa if given a chance. So she was like, then she started. Then she came up with her experience, how she liked a random walk, how it was an icebreaker. Then there is a LEAD program which happens initially for a month, I guess, in which they go to some lake in Wisconsin. So I asked her about that. Then the third question, which she liked the most, I asked her that there are so many things going on in Chicago booth. How do you manage time? So she was like, it's very difficult. The one thing that you have to get rid of is fear of missing out, FOMO, because people in booth at times have FOMO. So it was very conversational, and she being second year student, so it was like just talking to a senior rather than getting interviewed.
So I mean, from the look of it, it looks like you already have an admit from NYU, which is a top 10 business school in the world. And from the look of it, from what you told me, it looks to me that you were able to build a very good rapport with the second year student at booth as well. So I'm hoping that you will definitely get through. And which program are you inclined towards? Let's just assume that you get an admit to both the business schools. Which one do you sort of look to pick?
I want to work in quantitative finance. So both these colleges are very good in finance, and they are very robust career services in financial, and they are very good alumni network in finance. But I will go for both because the program is very flexible, and the quantitative rigor that Booth has in finance courses. So all the finance courses, even the class that I attended, that towards the end it became very quantitative, and I believe hardly 5-6 of the entire batch was following what Raghu Ramarajan was saying, because it became so quantitative at one point of time. So yeah, the quantitative nature of Booth program, along with Chicago, I mean Chicago, I like Chicago. And I feel that it's better than New York. New York is very, I mean, busy city, similar to Mumbai. So I would like to go to Chicago if given an opportunity.
Perfect. So thank you so much for your time, Ashish. I think
Thanks,
this is where we
Akshay.
can wrap up the interview.